Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Let's Code, a Windows Store app. Today I would like to add a timer to keep track of how long the player is busy on the puzzle. Therefore I have to do a small refactoring for the ticker. So let's get right to it. Let's open the JavaScript file and head way down to the ticker. This is the part I would like to refactor. At this point, the stage is updated, and because I would like to update the timer on every tick, this has to become a method. Because the stage is defined inside the init function, we're going to have to move this out of there. Now it's outside, so we can use this inside the next method. Let's call this update and add a new function. Function update, and in here we can call the stage.update method. This will cause the stage to update as it is working right now. Next, I would like to add the time. We have the game object, which contains the moves the player has made. We're going to add a new property there called time. This time value is going to hold the number of seconds the game is in progress. It's already bound to the screen right here, so we get to the UI in just a second. We're going to update the game time right here, and for that we need to initialize the start time of, because JavaScript doesn't have a time object, we'll use the date object. So let's call it start time equals new date to get the formatting there. And we pass this another new date from which we subtract the start time. And this will cause the time to update every tick. From that method, we're going to take, from that result, we're going to take the number of seconds. There. And all that's left to do at this moment is updating the UI. So I'm going to add paragraph around score, and then copy this, and then that time, the inner text will be the time property. Let's default it to 0, and I think this should be it. And as you can see, the timer is running. It doesn't interfere with moving around. Well, that's it for this episode. Next time, I would like to do some more refactoring and move the whole game code outside the default JS file into his own namespace and class, and maybe add some game state that whenever the game pauses, the timer stops and the updating stops. So we can work further on that and save the game state to local storage, etc. So thank you for watching and hope to see you again next time. See ya.